Hello everyone, this is Brandon, aka Go Elements, Auto Works. I wanted to give you an update regarding the Silver SL500. Now, I have to be honest, okay? I have to confess that my initial plan was to do the coilover swap. But because I have so much going on, I decided to buy myself some time. My intent has not changed. I still want to do the coilover swap because that one only has 100,000 miles. And I want to keep that car and drive that car and enjoy that car without having to worry about this 16-year-old ABC suspension, hydraulic fluid suspension. So what I wound up doing is on eBay, I found someone who had about six, two, four, six, six or eight lines from their ABC suspension available, and I bought all of them. I just went on here and bought them all, and I used the one. There was one particular one that he had that I needed to use for that car. It was the one that I had borrowed from that car to fix this one. Okay, so that line that runs from the front to the rear driver's side, I used that line, right? I put that back in this one. The other line that I needed, though, the initial line on here that initially had busted, he didn't have the exact line because there's two lines that run side by side. They almost run parallel, right? And of the six to eight lines that he gave me, it was the other line that runs parallel. So it was shaped different. Even though the ends were the same, because they kind of went to the same valve block, but they were shaped different. That being the case, I mean, obviously, I got these lines for cheap. I got them dirt cheap. I got like eight lines for like $100, less than $100. So I kind of did a band-aid fix. So I replaced the line. I kind of retrofitted the line instead of running along the engine compartment, inside the engine compartment behind the heat shield. I did it behind the strut in the wheel well. And I routed it through. I had to bend a little bit. I had to maneuver it. I created some brackets and some braces from old ABC parts that I had and secured it out of the way. And it works. But again, I mean, okay, so now the ABC lines are complete. The system is intact. It's a closed system again. But we're back to the original problem that I had with this ABC suspension. That being, at idle, it raises up and down. When you hit a bump, I'm sure the red ABC warning light will come on again. So those problems haven't changed. Like, all I did was just fix the busted line. I can't live like this, okay? I can't have a CL with ABC suspension that's not reliable, okay? I don't care how beautiful those cars are and how well they perform. You want your suspension to work, okay? If you had a Bentley or a Lamborghini and the suspension was questionable, would you even feel safe driving it? Would you feel safe pulling it out, showing it off, or just having a good night on the town and you have to worry about your suspension acting up? You have to explain yourself why your suspension is raising up and down at idle. I mean, that's silly. It's just silly. Also, I had to buy some time with that one because I have another project here. Somebody brought me their car. This is not mine. Somebody brought it to me. This is a 2007, I think, CLK 500. All right, so a good friend of mine knows what I do, and he wants me to do some work on it. He has a couple issues with it because it's not my car. I don't want to explain what the issues are, but this is something that, you know, somebody trusted me to fix, and he's going to take care of me regarding that. So I do appreciate when people appreciate, I guess, my work, my talents, you know, what it is that I do. I appreciate that. But the downside of that is people who have these Mercedes, they know how much these Mercedes cost to maintain. And so oftentimes they bring them to me and say, hey, can you fix it? How much would you charge me to fix it? And I enjoy the money that comes along with that, but it takes me away from some of my other projects, things that I want to do. I still have a lot of plans for this thing. I still have some more audio upgrades and some video. I want to incorporate some more audio and video into that car to make it more custom. I can't really explain all the stuff that I want to do to it because I don't want anybody to copy my ideas. But I have some pretty cool stuff that I want to do to this car. And so I never even talk about the S550 because it just sits here in my driveway. I drive it every now and then. But I've only had to do a few things to it since ownership. And it drives good. And it's a car I can just jump in and just feel, you know, I guess, feel good rolling. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and end this video. So my wife just opened up the door. So she gave me the look like, come on in the house. She need help with these kids. So I'm going to go ahead and go. All right, guys. We'll talk about these other cars later. All right. I'll make another video. We'll talk about the S550. Okay. We'll talk some more about the CL. And then I'll keep updating you with this because, like I said, I still intend on doing a coilover suspension. I just bought myself some time so that I can work on some other things. I want to get this convertible top taken care of on here. I got to get into that cylinder. Okay. I got to figure out what's going on with that. This car is too nice to be sitting here without the top being operable. The other cars are cool. The GL550, the GL450, those are cool. Okay. Again, I got to start working on that because I'm on a time frame. So I have to use my time wisely. Okay. So I will get off this video before I get in trouble with my wife. And I'll talk to you all later. And until then, peace out.